Here we have an Eli Terry Mantle clock. I believe the reverse glass painting was restored at one point. Quite nice. I have the movement out already. And scan up to the top here. Quite nice, painted. Don't know if it's gold leaf or not. And some more painting down the sides. Here we have the label. 8-day clocks invented by Eli Terry. The clock was brought to me with these weights that were done by a previous repairer. They put on this huge chunk of weight to compensate for a badly running movement. And you'll see in a second why you should never put extra weight on these clocks, because the wooden movement has teeth that are barely holding their own, let alone if you put extra weight, like that one's got extra weight as well. There's the back. The putty looks relatively new, but the customer says it's about 30 years old. It has catgut for the weights, and next you'll see the movement. Next on the bench is an Eli Terry wooden movement clock. It needs some major repairs. In the past, repairers have replaced some teeth. Not quite sure what wood they use. It almost looks like a phenolic kind of wood. It's kind of reddish. It might be purple heart, but it's a little too red for that. It's got catgut. Got to get rid of that. Has many broken teeth, as you can see there. That's just for the count wheel, though. There's no pressure on that. But where the teeth are really busted is on the striking great wheel, I believe that this is. And also the pinion that drives this particular wheel has some broken teeth on it as well. There's another tooth that was replaced right there. It's not a very difficult mechanical movement. Has a brass escape wheel on it. It looks to be a recoil escapement. The bushings that are in there don't look real, like pressed in or anything. I think what they did, they simply drilled out or used a certain type of a drill that hollowed out the plate where you see it and put that little ring around it, even though there's no extra piece that was put inside there. Previous repairs have done quite a bit of work to this guy. The fan governor here has no movement. It's completely seized up. It's got glue everywhere. I wonder what that stuff is. You don't think it's grease, do you? No, it's not grease. It's some kind of glue. Quite a large movement. Interesting the way they put all the pegs in from the top. I guess that's to stop them from falling out. And let gravity kind of hold them in there. The suspension spring was missing. When the customer brought it, they said that it was there when they got it out of the house, so it probably fell down in their driveway or something. Let me put all these little pegs into a little bucket here. That escape wheel is going to be coming up and out. We might as well take off the verge here so there's no damage that won't be happening to it. Doesn't look like anything else is needing to be addressed right now.